This screencast is about the difference between the entrance region and the fully developed region in a pipe. So if you look at this picture right here of a pipe, if you notice, we have a constant velocity going in, and then as soon as it hits the pipe wall, because we have the no slip condition at the wall, in other words, the fluid takes the velocity of the wall, which is zero, what are created are things called boundary layers. And so these boundary layers, which go along the pipe, create a viscous region. However, we have here in the center an inviscid core. So this continues until the boundary layers meet right here. And as soon as they meet and become one viscous area, we now have what is known as fully developed flow. So fully developed flow means that du dx equals zero, or in other words, u does not change with respect to x. It may change and does change with respect to r, but not with respect to x. Another interesting thing about this entrance region is in the inviscid core, because there are no viscous effects, we can apply Bernoulli's to any two points in that core. So now let's look at an example. So let's say we have water. It's at 20 degrees C and it enters a lead pipe with a diameter of 10 centimeters and a length of 8 meters. The volumetric flow is 15.85 gallons per minute. And what we want to find is that entrance length, as well as figure out, does the flow become fully developed? So what does that mean? What it means is if the entry length is greater than 8 meters, the entire pipe is still the entrance region and we don't have any fully developed flow. So the two governing equations for this entry length depend on the flow regime. So this one right here is for laminar flow, and this one is for turbulent flow. So how do we determine whether we have laminar or turbulent flow? Let's take a look. If you notice, both of them depend on the Reynolds number. So let's calculate the Reynolds number. So the Reynolds number is rho density times the velocity times the diameter divided by the viscosity. We don't have velocity. However, what we do have is a volumetric flow rate. So we can write the Reynolds number in terms of Q and look up our properties of water at 20 degrees C. And so our viscosity is 1.002 times 10 to the minus 3 newton seconds per meter squared. Our density equals 998 kilograms per meter cubed. We rewrite our Q, which is 15.85 gallons per minute, and we want to put that in the same units. So 1 minute is 60 seconds, and there are 0.0037 meters cubed per 1 gallon, and we therefore end up with 0.001 meters cubed per second. Our diameter is 10 centimeters, which is 0.1 meters. And so we can calculate our Reynolds numbers using these properties, which is 12,860. So what tells us whether it's laminar or turbulent? Well, anything over a Reynolds number of 4,000 in a pipe is considered turbulent. Therefore, we use that the entry length is 4.4 times Reynolds to the 1/6 times the diameter, which is 2.125 meters. So that means that in our pipe, which is 8 meters long, as soon as we get to 2.125 meters, the flow here is now fully developed.